Mark is. I miss Mrs. Mark.
So,
we're going to show you a very cool move. I call this thread the needle. When you thread a needle, you gotta put your hand, you gotta put that thread in that little slot.
Focus.
This is somewhat similar to that because of how I'm taking my left hand and kind of threading it into the right arm. First, we'll show it to you. Just so I have to bring one. Right to right to begin, just for the move. I'll show you the way. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, and 10. All right. It's like a hand change, transition to a nice turn. She ends up right back where she started. Okay. This begins. As if you wish, you can get fancy with the move and do a whip and whipper. Switch hands. And then you get into a right to right. However you want to do a right to right starting point leaders, you can go with that. There's so many things you can do. Okay, but to make it simple, right to right. First part of this is a sugar tuck for the partner. So we're just gonna do a sugar tuck. It's 6 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. It's a full turn to a right. I'm just taking my right hand. That's not move. That's how it feels when you start. Okay? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. But on the 5 and 6, I'm gonna take my left hand and I'm gonna transition into a threading the needle. So we're gonna try and stop on that next turn. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now I'm taking my left hand. I'm transitioning it up over. Let me try to move it this way. And I'm going to move over so you can't see me. I'm not really more explicitly here, but as she's turning, I'm taking this hand and I'm transitioning to make it come on top of her right forearm. So I'm kind of threading and connecting with it. Still holding the hand that I started with, but I really want to thread, move up, and connect with her because this is the hand I'm using to finish the move. So the whole thing. Get the hand change. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And once I get to 6, I can let go of the right hand, and then I turn 7, 8, 9, and 10. And I'm taking my right hand away, and the left hand does it on her own. So let's go. She didn't know
anything.
It's okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And I get my forearm, I let go of the right hand, triple, and then I put it back to close. Okay? So I'm not really moving. She's going back where she was, but I'm raising the hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Come up, go underneath the connected hand to the forearm, let go of the hand I've been using, turn to her left, and then we finish. It's not that difficult, but to break it down like that, that's not normal, that's kind of cool. That's why we do it.
It's fancy
life. It's fancy
life. So
not like that. Not like that. Right to right. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, and 8, 9, and 10. I can put my left arm on her back. She's turning just so she feels comfortable, more secure to go that she's going back where she started. Okay? It's not a very difficult move, not a very long move, but it's cool when you can get that threading smooth enough to where she doesn't realize it's over. Hand chain and all that till you're done. That's what makes it cool. That's what at least I think so. Ms. Lauren thinks so.
I do.
Hope you like it as well, guys. Give us that thumbs up. We'd appreciate it. And as always, I can't thank you enough for allowing us to share our passion for dance with you every time we're here on YouTube. So until next time, wise advice from a talented lady.
Keep dancing.